All right. What is going on, everybody? It is your boy Brian again with another great episode of Brian's Beverage Corner. And today we are going to be talking about the pros and cons of making your own six pack. Now, I just was lucky enough to have this six pack holder laying around the house to hold everything. The beers I did go out to buy, I actually just got them just put in a bag and brought home. But before we go into the beers, we'll talk about what it really is to make your own six pack at stores. Basically, a lot of people will go to the store and either buy a full six pack of one item, or some places like, as you can see here, this is from Total Wine, or other craft beer places will let you take a holder and will charge you individual prices for individual cans of whatever you're looking for, or whatever they're going to offer as a single. And there's a lot of good that comes out of it, but there's also like some things that kind of make it a negative depending on how you look at it. For someone like me, a big pro is that if you want to try something new, or if you do something like this for a show, it's easy to get a wide variety. And maybe something you would never usually try before, you don't have to buy a full six pack of it. You can buy a single one and, you know, enjoy whatever it is that you want. If you're a if you're someone that likes a certain style of beer, you can fill it with six different individual beers, but of the same style. And if you're not, then hey, you know, or if it's easy to try something, because then if you do like something, you can go out and buy the full six pack of it. You're not held down to a single item for all six beers. You can have a full variety, a full stock, if mind you. Also, you don't have to necessarily buy a full six pack. They do sell them at individual prices. So if you want four or two or three, you can buy as many or as little as you like. And you don't have to worry about overbuying or buying too much beer or buying something you may not like for that expensive. For example, getting a beer such as this one, which we're going to go over today, this beer individually was pretty expensive. But the four pack or six pack price might have been way over the top, and I don't have to spend that money and I can try the one. Which brings me to the first con, which is the price. You know, you may get a big variety, or you may get a big plethora of options for you to choose from, but you're also paying an individual can price, which usually winds up driving up your six pack price through the roof. You know, you may go out and get a general craft six pack for like, I don't know, like $8 to $12. Whereas now your six pack's probably costing you like double that, because you might have bought six items that are all $5 each. But a big pro is a lot of places also do deals for it. They'll give you a certain section and they'll say, if you make the six pack's $10.99, six pack's $11.99, or so on and so forth. So there is a lot of good that comes out of it. Another con is if you do wind up buying random stuff, you do run the risk that you're going to buy six items of something you don't like. So you take the risk, but it's worth it in the end. So now on to the beers that we'll be trying today. So we will try all six beers throughout the shows, but today we're going to hit on three specific ones I picked out, not for any specific reason. Well, actually, because they're the lowest ABVs. So I didn't want to drink anything too heavy today. So the first one we're going to do is, if I can get it out, here we go. So the first one we're doing today is the Strawberry Blonde Tart Sour Ale from Devil's Canyon Brewing Company. They are out of San Carlos, California. I don't know much about the brewery. I've actually never heard of them. I went to a local shop downtown in downtown San Diego called Best Damn Beer Shop. And they had a lot of interesting stuff that I've never seen in New Jersey, stuff that I've never seen. And I'm pretty sure I wound up buying a lot of just California local without thinking about it. I know a couple of them in the six-pack are from San Diego. So I bought those with the intent that they were local. But let's see how this comes out. I'm excited. So right off the bat, you can see, as compared to yesterday's beer, which was very like light straw color, I can smell this one from here. So the thing, so for those of you who have seen the show before, I love sour. I love sour beers. I think they're awesome. They're very fruity. They're very, I don't know. I just like that sour tartness to it. But this one you can see off the bat is more of, if my camera adjusts, is more of a, like, almost, I don't want to say gold, but definitely a darker, definitely regular ale color. So we're going to see how that, so this beer comes in at 5.3%. So still very light. So not too thick, not too strong. It should obviously taste like strawberry, like strawberries, but we'll see how it comes out. Wow. Okay, that's really, really tart. That's like lip puckering tart right there. It's not bad though. It really isn't that bad. Oh man. Oh, dude, Eric's in the chat. What's up, bro? But yeah, I mean, your basic sour ale. It has a hint of strawberries to it. The strawberries not super potent in it. It is in the smell, but definitely that tartness definitely overtakes it. So I'm wondering if they have anything on here about how it's fermented. Oh, here you go. Medium-bodied ale brewed with fresh strawberries. Incredibly complex, perfectly tart. It is perfectly tart, though. That you can taste it right off the bat. Now, going back to the six packs, four packs. Hi, Pete. going back to the six packs, four pack style, stuff like that. If you're not a sour drinker, but you wanted to try something because you love strawberries, but this is way too tart for you, you're not held down to four or six of these. Paying up to maybe like $15 for a six pack, depending on how rare this specific beer is or how local it is. But wow, that's a really tart beer. Very good though. Very good. Wow, Pete. Now the whole world knows. So the next beer we're gonna try is the one I showed earlier in the preview. It's called OXO, I guess is the name of it. Very, very simplistic can style, by the way, for this one. It's by a company that's literally called The Good Beer Company, and they're out of Santa Ana, California. This beer comes in at 5.5%. It is a – I looked this up one up online because I've never heard of this before. It's a Gooster – Gooster Traminer, sour wild ale with grapefruit zest. Basically that means they took the Gooster Traminer grape, which is used to make German wines, and they brewed it with those grapes to give it that extra essence to kind of bring out more of that tartness. This one's also a sour. It's a wild sour ale. So that means that all the flavor, all the sweetness and or tartness is all naturally occurring. There's no added like saltpeter or yes. And you did hear that right. Cause some people I did it in the sour episode. We talked about like the different like sea salts and all the different products they use. So I may be a little off on the information, so don't hold that against me. But this one, just like I just saw the can, and the place I went to downtown, like I said, it was called a Damn Good Beer Shop. It's owned by, I think it's called like Cress Beverages. I just saw like 50 of these different, like all different styles with different names on it. And I didn't know which one to pick. And this one just jumped out to me for whatever reason. So let's get into this. I'm excited. So this one was expensive. I don't remember how much the Devil's Canyon was for one can. I think it was like $4.99. I spent a lot on this six pack, if you can't tell. Ooh, that's a very interesting smell to it. So this can by itself was $7.50. And, oh, yeah. And for upcoming, so I am coming home soon. And thank you, Eric, for reminding me about this. So Eric texted me the other day, and him and Pete told me that they have a beer from Departed Souls Brewing out of Jersey City. and it's a donut beer. I don't know if it was Krispy Kreme or something like in like local donut shop, but they made like a chocolate donut or a jelly donut like beer, and they told me I have to try it. So when I come home and we do a more studio episode, I'm gonna do that beer, and it's gonna be awesome. I gotta stop rolling the sleeves up. So right off the bat, you can tell same thing as the first one. Definitely darker in color, not as bubbly as the first one. The smell though is 100% different. You definitely get a little bit of that grapefruit smell. And Eric just sent me the photo of it. Thank you, Eric. You definitely get a little bit of that grapefruit zest. They basically just like shredded the skin to give it that flavor and that aroma to it. But it's not that potent, not that strong of a smell. Okay. That's interesting. I don't want to call it weird because it's not bad. It's definitely not bad. But it's interesting because you're getting almost like a vino taste to it. And it's just, I don't know. I can't really put it into words right now. But imagine like almost like a wine beer. And Dogfish Head does one too. Dogfish Head does a beer called Mixed Media, which uses Viognier grapes and sour ale, and it's the closest thing to a wine that a beer could ever be, is what they advertise it as. This is kind of like that, but not as strong. This is a very light taste. I think if you're a sour drinker and you just like a basic sour, I think you'd like this one a lot better than the Devil's Canyon. Granted, if you're a hardcore sour drinker, or if you're a strawberry lover, definitely go with the Devil's Can. Definitely go with the strawberry blonde. It is a little bit, obviously, like the percentage isn't that different, but this is really good. I'm really glad I picked this. Yeah, so we've done a lot of sours. I'm a little biased because I love sour ales. The last beer we're doing today is not a sour, although one of the other ones in the six-pack I bought is also a sour, but we're not doing it this week. But going back to mentioning, you can buy whatever you like in a six-pack, and it's awesome. And I think all liquor stores or all places that sell beer should look into the option of doing singles. Now, granted, it's a lot of extra work for like on the business end, and it's not as much of a money maker for the business, which is why a lot of places tend not to do it. Also, if your clientele mainly consists of like your Bud Light, Miller Lite, like your basic beer drinkers, they're not going to buy like one beer. They might buy the big tall boy singles, like 24-ounce cans, but they're not going to buy like a 12-ounce bottle or like the 40-ounce maybe, but who knows. The last beer we're doing today is very interesting. This caught my eye last second at the store when I was looking for that last can, and it was on like the top shelf behind like everything else. Let me just pull the price tag off. So here's the front of the can. This is actually called Birdhouse IPA by Black Plague Brewing Company out of Oceanside, California. This is based on Birdhouse, the skateboarding company, like Tony Hawk. You can see his kind of Birdhouse logo on the back with his name on it. His name's on it twice. So this is basically a standard IPA, nothing crazy. I looked it up. Comes in at 6.5%, and this can was $2.50. So if you go for the smaller cans, like the 12-ounce cans, like they're going to obviously be a lot cheaper depending on what the product is. So this one was only $2.50 compared to the other two, which were double or almost triple the price. So for the show and as the show progressed, I mean, I worked at a liquor store and we did sell singles, but not that much. It was kind of like whatever we had abundance of, we would do singles, or like a new item that came out that not a lot of people were buying, we'd do singles to try to promote them. And it worked for a little bit, but then it wound up just being whatever wasn't getting sold got put into singles so that we can make space. but a lot of bigger stores like Total Wine, like out here in California, we have BevMo, should do it. And then this, and any specific beer place will have a single section, which is cool. So right off the gate, I can tell this is already lighter in color. Not going to be lighter in flavor because it's going to be an IPA style. So you can see, obviously, a little bit foamier at the top. Maybe it was my pour speed, maybe not. But once again, I always talk about artwork. I love artwork for cans. I keep the cans. I'll do an episode where I'll go over like my can collection. The one I have out here might be a little bit easier because they're not as many as the one at home. But like, they took his skateboarding logo, like his skateboarding logos and pictures and stuff like that, and basically created a solo artwork for the can. And I even like the little plague doctor, especially right now with everything going on in the world. Like, that's kind of cool to me, at least. So let's see. All right. Strong hops off the top. Like the aroma, strong hops off the top. Nothing too crazy. I don't like, they didn't promote any extra like flavoring added, any extra anything. So I'm kind of excited because this is going to be your straight up flat IPA. Nothing crazy. So it smells like a normal IPA. Nothing weird out of it. Yeah, it's basic, super basic. This is no added nonsense, no nothing. It's an IPA, little bit of hops. Yeah, right. Eric says Bev Corner is going to be put in smell-o-vision. But it's generic. It's basic. If you're an IPA drinker, I would try it. I would go out and spend the $2.50 on this, no problem. I would buy a 6-pack of this. You can sit outside, and today, obviously, you can tell from my lighting because yesterday was a lot darker. It's sunny out today in California, so not like it usually isn't, but the last week or so, we've had a lot of rain. But it's cool. It's good. I like companies that don't you can put whatever you want into your beers, and like, I'm not saying that adding a little extra flavor would be bad, but it is cool to see that there are companies that stick to the basics. And they do it good. And they do, or they do it well, I should say, proper English. It is a little hoppy. Like, if you're not a regular IPA drinker, you're probably gonna be like, "Oh, that's really hoppy. That's really hoppy." For someone that has like studied the craft and has like tried a lot of beers, like this isn't that hoppy to me. It's not like you're buying like what is it, like gangster, like a gangster frog from Hopping Frog Brewing, or like their Hop Dam, which has like an IBU off the chart. Let me see if it has the IBUs on here. I didn't see it before, but I could have overlooked it. No, this is a very generic, very punk rock style can, and I like it. It's cool. I would definitely, if they had more of this, I'd definitely go back and buy another can or two. But yeah, so that's why I go to make my own 6-packs. I believe that, especially for the show, it makes it easier to buy products for shows. It makes it easier for someone who is a beer connoisseur, or is someone that goes out and wants to try something different, to experience a whole realm. And obviously, like in the winter, like my 6-packs and the show is going to be more stout based, more winter beer, winter lagers, winter ales, whatever's coming out. And my seasonal episodes will be very 6-pack oriented to what's going on in the world. Like obviously right now we're just restarting the show and I'm really happy to see people tuning into this. And I'm happy to see that people are coming afterwards that can't make it to watch the episodes. So I really do appreciate you guys like and everything. But we're going to so just like when we were filming in the studio, I will be bringing you this show at least once a week, depending on how much money I want to spend at the moment and how much time I have. Because right now I am still working, like I am still working 5 days a week through this little pandemic we got going on here. You never notice in California, in San Diego, though, because everyone's still on the road. But whatever, man. So far out of this 6-pack, 482. Hell yeah, dude. Big shout out to Session 482, man. That's my academy class. I love you, Timmy D. You know that. I hope I see you too when I come home. Big shout out to Timmy D. But yeah, so that's the episode for today. Definitely check out this episode. If you well, obviously, if you're not watching it, you've already missed it. But if you didn't watch yesterday's episode, I'm a little bit more awkward because I got super nervous to do the show. But now I'm like, now I'm in the zone today, and I'm really excited to bring it back. I have beers lined up for next week. We're gonna aim for Thursday at 3 p.m. Eastern time, noon Pacific time. And yeah, Eric's going to make a couple artwork designs for us for the show. And the first couple are going to be live streamed just like this. And then when I'm home, we're going to hopefully we don't have to social distance ourselves, so that we can all sit on that lovely couch and be absolutely maybe 1 to 2 inches from each other. But other than that, I mean, I'm so happy you guys came out to watch the episode today. Thank you guys so much. And until next time, I'm Brian. And this has been Brian's Beverage Corner. Have a great day, guys, and enjoy your beer responsibly.